Time now for the Media Monitor, our weekly look at the hits and errors in the news business. Now, this is strange. Matthew Keyes, a social media editor at Reuters, is disputing charges that he helped the shadowy group Anonymous hack into computers at the Tribune Company where Keyes had been fired. Reuters has suspended Keyes after the indictment, but his lawyer told the Huffington Post that Keyes was engaged in undercover-type journalism and is being prosecuted for going after the story. We shall see. Well, it sure sounded like a scoop. Us Weekly reporting last week that The View had decided to dump Elizabeth Hasselbeck because, the story said, the audience didn't like her conservative views. Now, despite a denial by the ABC show, that piece was picked up by so many websites, I lost count. Then Barbara Walters made this announcement.
There is a particularly false story that keeps getting picked up about Elizabeth's alleged departure, saying that we don't approve of her conservative views. The truth is, we love Elizabeth. I like her personally, and she's just a wonderful person. But beyond that, we value and appreciate her point of view.
Has Us apologized for the erroneous story? Nope. Here's what the magazine says. A source tells it that the denial is part of a strategy to save face for both Hasselbeck and the series before she resigns on her own. Is that true? Who knows? If you looked at National Review's website this week, Joe Biden sounded pretty insensitive thanks to some deceptive editing. Here's how the conservative magazine depicted the vice president talking about different types of domestic violence.
For example, if an abuser has attempted to strangle his victim, if he's threatened to shoot her, if he sexually assaulted her, and there's a number of other signs, about eight others, these are telltale signs to say, this isn't your garden variety. Slap across the face.
Yes, the tape clumsily cut off Biden right there in mid-sentence, but as Mediaite reported, National Review later restored the vice president's full sentence.
These are telltale signs to say, this isn't your garden variety. Slap across the face, which is totally unacceptable in and of itself.
Totally unacceptable. National Review's Nathaniel Bothwinick posted an apology saying he had edited the video in haste. I guess it just looked deliberate.